Good morning, grade 3. A warm welcome to today's English lesson. This week we're going to read lesson 13, Yonder Mountain, which is a Cherokee legend. And in this lesson we're going to learn how to analyze and evaluate characters, actions and traits, and we'll be using details from your textbook in order to answer some questions. So let's begin. Now, please do not forget to pause this video and replay it for better understanding. Great, so I want you to open your R&B books to page 193 and 194. And alongside, I also want you to open the lesson that's saved in e-resources before you start attempting at answering these questions. Let's look at page 193 and read the instructions. A scene from Yonder Mountain. You're going to tell the story of Yonder Mountain as a play. Fill in the different parts with details from the story. Let's read the first instruction. Read pages 473 till page 475. Use what you read on this page to write a script for Chief Sky. Help him tell the audience how the three young men are alike. What do they want? What do they do? So let's read page 473 first. I'll show you how to do it. Let's read. Chief Sky has grown too old to lead his people, and he's looking for someone to replace him. What is he looking for in a new chief? Find out by reading this Cherokee legend. Once in the land of the Cherokee people, there lived a beloved chief called Sky. Chief Sky had seen many summers and winters. He had led his people through long seasons of peace. He had seen their warriors go through great battles with enemies. But now his step was slow, and his hand trembled on the bow. He could no longer spot brother deer among the trees. He was no longer able to lead his people. Let's go to page 474. One day in the season of falling leaves, the chief called three young men to him and said, "One of you will take my place and become chief and lead our people. But first, I must put you to the test." Chief Sky turned slowly, looking into the distance. "Do you see Yonder Mountain?" The three young men followed the gaze of the chief and saw a great mountain rising out of the mist in the distance. "Yes," they answered, "we see the mountain." Chief Sky pointed towards the highest peak. "I want you to go to the mountain top. Bring back to me what you find there." So after reading these three pages, let's try answering this question. So tell us, what do these three men wanted and what will they do? So what do you think is the answer? And the answer is, these three men all want to be the new chief. They will all climb the mountain and bring something back. So when we read, we comprehend and we find these details within the text to answer this question. Now let's go to the next instruction. All right, grade 3, let's read the next instruction. Read pages 476 all the way to 480. Use these pages to help Black Bear and Grey Wolf tell the audience about their adventures. So let's begin reading together. This is page 476. We're going to read all the way to page 480. Okay. The first young man called Black Bear quickly started up the side of the mountain. After the sun reached the middle of the day, Black Bear came to a wide place in the trail where he stopped to rest. He leaned his head upon a rock and his eyes grew heavy. Just as his eyes were closing, he caught sight of a thousand lights twinkling in the sun. Black Bear sat up straight and saw stones of great beauty lining each side of the trail. They sparkled and glowed in the sunlight. Black Bear examined the stone, carefully turning it over and over in his hand and watching the sun dance on each surface. "If my people had these stones, they would never be hungry again," he said. "We could trade them for food and our lives would be better." Great, so here on this page we've read that Black Bear goes up the trail, finds some shiny black stones, and decides that he could trade these, his people could trade these, and never go hungry again. Let's read ahead. Black Bear gathered many sparkling stones and ran down the mountain and back to his village. The people saw him coming and lined the path as he entered the village. The children pointed to the sparkling stones and said, "See the pretty stones Black Bear has found?" Black Bear handed the stones to the chief Sky and said, "My chief, look what I have found. Beautiful stones." We can trade them for food and we'll never go hungry. We will be safe through many winters. The chief smiled fondly upon the young man and said, "You've done well, my son. You've done well. Let us now wait for the others." So Black Bear found the sparkly stones and brought them to the chief and thinks that he can take away the hunger for many winters ahead for his people. Great. Let's see what Grey Wolf found. The second young man called Grey Wolf climbed the mountain and went past the place of the sparkling stones. Okay, so that's the difference. Went past the place of the sparkling stones. He climbed higher and higher. The trail became steep and rugged. So he's going higher. Finally, he came to an open place where he rested beside the trail. He picked an herb, looking closely at it to point the leaves and long roots. "These are the healing plants of our medicine man," he said. "If my people have these herbs and roots, they will no longer be sick and suffer. We could be healed with these plants." Grey Wolf gathered one of each of the plants and hurried down the mountain. So Grey Wolf chose to go higher up and chose the plants, the healing herb plants. The people saw him coming and lined the pathway. The children waved and the elders said, "See all the herbs Grey Wolf has found? We will never be sick again." Grey Wolf ran to his chief and spread the plants before him. "Look, my chief, what I have found. We no longer need to suffer. I found all kinds of herbs and we can be healed." The old chief smiled fondly on Grey Wolf and said, "You've done well, my son. You've done well. Now let us wait for Soaring Eagle, our last young man." So, here's your answer. If Black Bear and Grey Wolf go about telling people about their adventures, how are they going to write it down? Short, precise, simple. Black Bear could say, "I climbed up the mountain. I saw sparkling stones. I knew my people could trade these stones for food. I ran back down to the village with some stones." So that's a narrative, right? Then Black Bear could write and the audience could read. What about the Grey Wolf? The Grey Wolf could say, "I also climbed up the mountain. I also saw the sparkling stones, but I didn't pick up the stones. Then I climbed higher and found herbs and roots that I could use to heal my people. I ran back down to the village." So this is the answer. Now you can see how we've been reading the text and we've been looking for answers, and we wrote the answers down in our own words. Short, simple, precise. These were 4 pages, and we've squeezed down the main points by answering this question that you just read and into 2 tiny paragraphs. You see how this is done. We looked into the main key points and we wrote down a narrative that Black Bear and Grey Wolf would have. Now, all right, grade 3, so I want you to attempt the remaining questions where you need to read and comprehend on page number 194 yourself. And don't forget to bring in your answers. We're going to reflect on them together. Remember, this is a very important reading comprehension practice. Now, it's time we wrap up this lesson. But before we do that, let's talk about some very famous Qatari legends and folktales. And the ones that I've quoted here are Hazavi El Awwalin. These are Qatari fairy tales that are passed from generations to generations. And I want you to research about these. And I'm going to post these links in today's e-post. This is taken from Qatar National Library. There was an event that took place that revolved around the Qatari legends and folktales. So do not forget to share with us any Qatari folktale or legend that you know. And don't forget to complete your work on page number 194. As to flood grade 3.